production of Mary Poppins. If you attended this morning's show, you already know what's in store for you, and I'm sure you're as excited as I am to see it for the second time. If this is your first chance, you are in for quite a treat. Just to let you know about our show tonight. So this is the 8th production here at Thomas Kelly since I came 4 years ago. This is our second summer production. And summer productions are special because we draw from the entire Sacramento area. So tonight our cast of 45 students is actually made up of approximately 10 different schools from as far out as Rockland. So really exciting. So for those of you who are not Thomas Kelly community members, I just wanted to let you know a little bit about our school. So our school started very small. When I came here 5 years ago, our school they actually thought was going to be closed because of numbers. And we had somewhere about 250 students, and we had several classrooms that stood empty, several. Now we have a wait list at every single grade level. I started teaching under a philosophy known as IB, which stands for International Baccalaureate. And if I had to define that in my teacher terms, I would tell you that we try to teach students that they're part of a global community, that their questions prompt the learning and drive the instruction, and my very favorite part is the strong character ed component. So we believe that it's not just important about what a student knows, but who they are on the inside that counts as well. And we measure that throughout the year. So some of the things that students are displaying here, whether they come to Thomas Kelly or not, I would say are still very present as far as being principled, being open-minded, learning to be an excellent communicator, learning to collaborate, and finally, and probably the most important, being courageous. These students that stand before you are performing not only for family and friends, but for complete strangers, and that takes a lot of guts. So, without any further ado, I would like to introduce our 2015 summer production of Mary Poppins.
That's why I say a good riddance. But who gets stuck with the nanny? Who gets stuck with the children with no nanny house? Me, that's who.
Now, Ellen, I wouldn't stay in this house for another minute, not if you gave me all the tea and china.
No, no, Kenny, and I don't go. What am I going to tell Mrs. Banks about the children?
That is no concern of mine. Those little bees have run away from me for the very last time.
They must be somewhere. Did you want those in the park? They like hanging on the cages. Don't you think they're going to eat them by the lions, do you?
Poor little mites. Even the lions could look after them better than this nanny. Let her go, that's why I say, and good riddance.
Now move out of my way!
Goodbye! Now, Kenina. Oh no, Mrs. Banks, she's home.
I shall be glad to have your help in the manor.
We thought you would, and that's why we wrote this advertisement for the new nanny.
You wrote an advertisement?
Now, George, I think we should listen.
But...
wanted a nanny for three adorable children.
Adorable, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition. Rosy cheeks, no warts, play games all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty.
Poor little mites.
Oh, how dreadful.
Looks like no one's getting up!
Ellen, it's precisely 8 o'clock.
You may now show the nannies in that one at a time.
Where are they?
Thank you.
Are you the father of Jane and Michelle Banks? Are you not? I said, are you the father of Jane and Michelle Banks?
Yes, I mean, have you brought your references? May I see them, please?
Oh, I make it a point to never give references. A very old-fashioned idea to my mind.
Oh, we'll see about that, won't we?
Now, the qualifications. Item 1, a cheery disposition. I am never cross. 2, rosy cheeks, obviously. Item 3, playing games, all sorts. I'm sure the children will find my games extremely different.
That letter, where'd you get it from?
Item 4, I'm kind but extremely firm. Have you lost something?
That paper, you see, I thought.
You are George Banks, are you not?
Mr. Banks, yes.
And you did advertise for a nanny, yes? I shall require every second Tuesday off.
Every second Tuesday.
I believe a trial period would be, guys. I'll give you 1 week. I'll know it then. Now I think I should see the children. Thank you. Close your mouth and tell me you're not popished. Well, don't just stand there. Let's get going. So let's walk.
George! What on earth are you doing? I thought you were interviewing nannies.
I was.
You mean you've already chosen one already? How clever of you, George. I knew I should leave it to you. Where is she?
Well, she's in the nursery, of course. I mean, I put her work straight away.
Will she be firm, George? Give commands?
Do you know? I think she will.
Like his house, ship-shaped dust, ship-shaped Bristol fashion at all times.
Time gun ready?
Ready, charge, sir.
8 minutes and 6 seconds.
Aye, aye, sir.
What he's famous for is his punctuality. The whole world takes its time from Greenwich, but Greenwich, they say, takes its time from Admiral Boone.
Watch your Admiral. New to you too, young man. Where are you bound?
To the rock, just the sidewalk off.
Watch it out to the log, though, buddy.
Right away, sir.
Good day.
Well, it's clean. It just needs a few touches. First things first, I need a hat stand to put my hat on. And my mirror, perfect as usual.
But there's nothing in there.
Now, Michelle, don't judge things by their appearance.
We'd better keep an eye on this one. She's tricky.
She's wonderful.
Where is my, where did I put it?
What?
My tape measure.
What do you need it for?
I want to see how you measure up. Ah, here it is. Heads up, don't slouch. Just as I thought, extremely stubborn and suspicious.
I am not.
Now you, Jane. Rather intellect giggle, doesn't put things away.
What about you?
Very well, hold this for me. As expected, Mary Poppins, practically perfect in every way.
Mary Poppins, is that your name? It's lovely.
Thank you, now shall we get on with it?
Get on with what?
In your advertisement, did you not specifically request to play games?
Oh, yes.
Very well then, our first game is well begun is half done.
I don't like the sound of that.
Otherwise, entitled, let's tidy up the nursery.
I told you she was tricky.
It's a game, isn't it, Mary Poppins?
In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. Find the fun and snap! The job's a game. And every task you undertake,
see you.
Yes, excellent, isn't it?
There probably aren't any words describing emotions.
Now, what's the word I'm thinking of? Come on, Mary, what is it?
Mary Poppins, just tell me what the word is.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
One night I said to me girl, now me girl's me wife.
Oh, and a lovely thing she is.
She's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Come on, buddy, step in time!
got a jolly joke I saved for just an occasion. Would you like to hear?
I'll be so grateful.
Well, it's about my granddad, see, and one night he has a nightmare. He was so scared he chewed his pills to bits. In the morning, I says, how you feel, granddad? He says, oh, not bad, a little down in the mouth.
She doesn't care what will happen to us.
She only said she would stay until the wind changed. Isn't that right, Mary Poppins?
Jane, bring me my hat.
Mary Poppins, don't you love us?
And what would happen to me, may I ask, if I love all the children I say goodbye to?
Yes, sir. George W. Banks, number 17, Cherry Tree Lane, about 6 feet tall. There's been no sign of him, and his family is very concerned.
Wouldn't hurt to drag the river.
Really, Helen?
He seemed to be such a fine gentleman, sir.
Medicine, go down, the medicine, go down.
Look, it's him! Or something that sounds like him.
George, oh George, you didn't jump into the river, did you? How sensible.
It's all right, sir. I think he's been found.
George, what happened to you? I've been sacked, discharged. Flung into the street. A spoonful of sugar helps some medicine go down.
Gone for his comfort, that's what he's done.
She went short of a picnic.
Where are the children? Jane, Anne, Michelle?
Your father is calling you.
It doesn't sound like father.
Children!
Run along, split spot.
You won't go, Mary, will you?
Split spot.
You meant it. However, did you manage?
With puppets and paper and string, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight. With your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
Mr.
Binnacle and Admiral Boone.
chimney sweeps.
Nico DeLaglio.
Adam Benassi.
It's St. Nice.
Nolan Burrows.
Logan Farron. The constable, the townsperson, and the household staff.
My sister.
Audrina Pierce.
Make me wanna shout, kick my feet on top and shout, throw my hands on top and shout, throw my hands.
the play during the school year, but I always thank you to people coming from other schools and trusting me for 3 hours a day with their children. I take that responsibility really, really seriously. And I just want to thank all of you for helping with the costumes and helping with the sets and the drawings and everything. And like I said, entrusting me with your children for 3 hours a day, 3 days a week. It's been a pleasure. It's always a sad night for me because I watch my imagination go bye-bye. So thank you. Chris, did you want to?
I've taught at 4 different schools in this district, and this is the only school that has a theater program like this. This is unique, and this is special, and I thought it was so special I even brought my own kids to this school because of it, and so it wouldn't be if it wasn't for these wonderful, wonderful women here. So I would like to recognize, of course, our director, Mrs. Lori Stuckmeyer. We also want to recognize Mrs. Kelly Simmons, our DJ. Mrs. Barbara Bailey. Where's Ms. Shulon, our choreographer? Thank you for all the wonderful dance moves that you saw. Miss Haley Struckmeyer. Before you leave tonight, we have one final request that you're going to help us to stack the chairs. So if you wouldn't mind folding your chairs and grabbing a couple, we're going to be, are they going to be outside the door? They're going to bring in, I have something else. But when you do leave, if you wouldn't mind stacking right now, they're in the process of bringing in the racks for those. But we also have one last gift for Ms. Struckmeyer and her amazing family, because this really is an entire Struckmeyer event. We had her husband and son in the back running your spotlight for you. So thank you to her entire family. Please stay for a group photo and make sure that you get autographs of your favorite cast members.